All right, we're back one more time at the Dry Down Lowdown, and guess what? I got a bottle of the brand new Paco Rabanne Phantom, which is a robot. Doesn't make any sense. You're calling it a phantom, it's a robot. And to pay homage to our older generation, we're going to call it a Robit. Because the old men like they used to like to say, yeah, I like them movies with the robots and then, you know, that kind of thing. So it's a goddamn robot. So let's just get on with it. Let's see what I thought about this new release. Oh, and I tried to get all kinds of fancy, use a green screen. But I learned a lesson here. If you use a green screen with a box that has a lot of reflective material on it, not so good. Not so good, not so easy to work with. But whatever, we're going to keep getting better here. I'm going to start figuring it out. It's going to be cool. Anyway, on with the goddamn video. Okay, so there it is. Paco Rabanne's Phantom. See, it says Paco Rabanne. It says Phantom. See, that's how we know what it is. So this is the box. I know some of you people enjoy stuff like that. The lid opens up. There's another lid and two more on the side. It's mind-blowing. How does it work? How does it work? Anyway, here's the robot. Pretty cool action figure type of thing. For a fragrance. Nice design. Interesting.
Oh yeah, I see what you mean. I don't think that's ever been done before.
The fuck's the matter with you?
Oh, nothing at all. Just continue with this dazzling review.
Anyway, as I was saying, there's a sleeve inside. How mind-blowing is that? Right? There's those four lids again. Ooh. Box porn. You know what I mean? What do you guys do with these things? You build a clubhouse or whatever? I don't know why you're so excited about this. Get this thing out of here. Anyway, so here's the robot again. Now, what's interesting about him?
Oh God, yes. Tell us what's interesting about him.
You're a jackoff. That's what I think of you.
Nice dice clay burn, robot. And I agree with the robot. You are kind of a jerk-off.
Yeah, because I'm the one doing a puppet show with fragrance bottles.
So if you look here, there's a Wi-Fi signal on the top. You put your phone to it and it loads an NFT.
Oh, right. For all the people who've been clamoring for a fragrance that requires a fucking data plan.
All right, enough of this nonsense. Let's get to the notes. Top notes are lavender, lemon zest, and Amalfi lemon. Now that sounds redundant, but it gets worse than that. On Fragrantica, which we talked about that you can't trust on the last video, they listed lavender at the top, at the mids, and at the base. So we're just gonna put it at the top, and then we're gonna move forward. Dig it? Good. Mids are apple, smoke, earthy notes, whatever the fuck that means, dirt, I guess, and patchouli. Base notes are vanilla and vetiver. And now that all the other nonsensical stuff is out of the way, we need to get down to what is important here, the dry down, and what do I think of Paco Rabanne's Phantom, or as I like to call him, the robot. Well, I like him. I think he smells pretty good. He doesn't smell like anything else that I own, which is why I bought him. I went to the store on the day that it was released because I didn't get an early special treatment like a lot of other people do, and I said, hey, you got that new Phantom robot? And they were like, yeah, we got the robot. And I was like, well, let me get a squirt of that so I can see what I think of it. And they squirted it and I went, yeah, that's all right. I'll take a bottle. And so I took a bottle and then I made a video for you here. The thing about it is, it's like the bear, right? The bear was acting up a little minute ago, but the bear smells like nothing else that I own. You probably don't have anything that smells like the bear either. And that's exactly how Paco Rabanne's Phantom is. I don't have anything that smells like it, and I got a bunch of stuff here. I don't have like one of them walls behind me, right? But I got a good clip of stuff, and it's different. And my woman enjoys it, which that's a plus, right? Now, are you gonna get compliments? No, of course not. You know, this isn't that special. This isn't something mind-blowing. It doesn't have a huge projection. I mean, maybe if you spray like 20-some sprays on you. By the way, I was watching that Curly fragrance again. She was talking about, oh, I put like 27 sprays. What is the matter with you? What are you doing? It's time for an intervention on her, Miss Frasch, or whatever the hell you call. You know, friends don't let friends overspray like that. You understand? This is a little ridiculous. I know it's like a kitschy thing to do, but...
Did you people know what 20-some-odd sprays must smell like? This is like chemical warfare. Anyway, back to the Robit. So, do I recommend you buy it? I mean, check it out first. It might not be for you. It's, like I said, it's not spectacular, but it's nice. I enjoy it, and my woman enjoys it, and maybe you'll enjoy it too. Now, as far as longevity goes, I wore it for an entire day. I wouldn't exactly call it a workhorse. It's serviceable, right? But after about 4 or 5 hours, it was really down to a skin scent. Wasn't much going on there. I even checked around. I said, hey, you still smell this? And the woman was like, hey, when I get real close, I do. So there's that. As far as the NFT thing goes, it takes you to some playlists on Spotify. I don't care. Doesn't do anything for me, but I guess it's a nice little novelty. So I guess all that leaves us with is the price. I paid $125 for 150 mil. I think that's a pretty fair price. Can you do better for that money? You certainly can, and we'll be talking about how in my next video. So until then, you know the drill, like, subscribe, or don't. See, I'm always leaving it up to you. Do it or don't do it. And I'll see you next time.